अस्तु भगवन् विश्वेश्वराय महादेवाय त्र्यम्बकाय त्रिपुरान्तकाय त्रिकाग्निकालाय कालाग्निरुद्राय नीलकण्ठाय मृत्युञ्जयाय सर्वेश्वराय सदाशिवाय श्रीमन् महादेवाय नमः.
Hi friends, this is NJ, host on this channel. So we will continue our discussion around different destiny numbers. The number which we are going to discuss today is the destiny number 7. And we will have our discussion on the same parameters which we have been following throughout in this series. First, we will try to understand the significance of the destiny number. Then we will try to understand the correct mechanism, the correct way of calculating someone's destiny number. And in the last, we will have an exclusive discussion on the destiny number 7. So the very first thing with which I always begin my discussion is that why you should study the destiny number. So that's very simple, like the way I have been repeatedly saying this thing in this whole series, that the life path number and the destiny number forms the core of any of the numerological chart analysis. Now this life path number which we get by making a sum total of someone's complete birth details. Now just because your date of birth is fixed, your year of birth is fixed, which cannot be changed. So this life path number is fixed, which just tells about the reason of your birth, the ultimate lesson which you need to learn in this lifetime and ultimately where you have to reach in this particular lifetime. The destiny number or the expression number, which we get by making a sum total of our complete name. This number just tells about the kind of environment and the opportunities which we are going to invite in our lifetime, the way we are being identified and recognized in this world, our physical and our mental constitution, the orientation towards the goal of our life. So all of that we get to know from our destiny or the expression number. Just because this name, by making a certain amendments in the letters of your name, you can change and mold the energy of this number. So you can definitely make it in sync with your chosen vocation, with the kind of energies you want to invite in your lifetime. So the very first thing, the very first thumb rule of the numerology is that these two numbers, the life path number and the destiny or the expression number, have to be in sync, have to be in harmony in order for someone to live a life filled with all kind of opportunities and in order to avoid any kind of obstacles in the life. Now comes the question of what is the correct way of calculating the destiny number or the expression number. So the reference example which we are going to discuss today is of the great tennis player Martina Hingis. So as you can see in your screen that she has her name as the Martina Hingis, and even she is worldwide recognized by the same name only, because many numerologists recommend that you should be relying on the name written in the birth certificate only. Though I beg to differ over there, because the name with which person is being recognized in the whole world, that name is going to generate the energy and that name is going to define more accurately the kind of aura, the kind of environment, the kind of talents which that particular individual possesses. So you need to do an analysis of both ways by yourself only, then land to any kind of conclusion. So the very first step towards calculating the destiny number is that you have to write down the numerical value for all the letters of the name. The number system which we are following in this playlist, in this series, is of the Pythagorean system. So we did that in the very first step. In the step 2, what you have to do is that you have to reduce the both entities of the name, like the way here we have a first name and we have a surname, we do not have a middle initial. So we will reduce the first name individually, independently, to a single digit, and we will do the same with the surname as well. So by making a sum total of all the numerical value of the Martina, the first name, will get the answer as the 31, which can be reduced to a single digit as the 4. And by summing all the numerical value of the surname Hingis, we will get the answer as the 39. By adding further 3 plus 9, you'll get the answer as 12, and this can be further reduced to a single digit as 3. In the final step, what we have to do is that we have to make a sum of both of these reduced, single reduced entities. So by making a sum of the 4 plus 3, we will get the answer as the 7. So Martina Hingis has her destiny number or the expression number as the 7. Now comes the part where we will have our discussion exclusively on the destiny or the expression number 7. Like the way we have already discussed the vibration of the number 7. 7 is a number which is being governed by the Ketu, the south node of moon. Western numerologists associate it with the Neptune. Now comes the question of the positive and the negative side of the vibration of the number 7, like the way we have discussed. In the positive side, this number represents all kind of analytics, you know, meditation, spirituality, occultism, perfection, invention, investigation, meditation, you know, teaching qualities, instructing qualities. On its negative aspect, this could represent inadaptability, lack of trust, which could give rise to all kind of, you know, aloofness, you know, little bit of the eccentricity, depression, hidden motives. So this is about the positive and the negative side of the vibration of this number 7. But you cannot ignore the fact that in the whole series from the number 1 till reaching number 9, this is the most spiritual, most mystic number. You know, we have the 7 energy centers in our body. This number has the capacity to make a sync of the body, mind and the soul. So this is all what we get to know from the positive and the negative side of the vibration of the number 7. But just because this number has appeared as your destiny number or the expression number. So let's say, for example, if you have chosen a vocation where you are working as a scientist, you are working as a researcher, explorer, you are a musician, you are a writer, you are a poet. So there you are going to get all the positive, you know, benefits of the vibration of this number 7. Just because, like the way I always say, this is a number, the destiny number or the expression number just means that only, that all that environment and the energies are going to be raised and invoked all around you only. So you might be getting all kind of opportunities, you might be getting deep down to a level of perfection or to a level of brilliance and making best use of the energy of this number, because this is a number of brilliance, this is a number of perfection. You know, you, whether it's about someone who is working as a doing a menial job of a carpenter or whether someone working as a surgeon, but the person will be a brilliant person, will be a perfectionist in his chosen field. So this is how we can correlate the positive and the negative side of the destiny number 7. The second part of our discussion on the this destiny number is that you have to always correlate it with your life path number, which is the very most important number. So let's say, for example, irrespective of the harmony of this number with other planetary numbers, if you have your life path number as the 1. Now, 1 is a number which is about being individualistic, reaching a position of power, position of authority. So with this destiny number, all what you're going to get is that you have to always, you know, believe in this fact that you have to remain very brilliant, you have to remain perfectionist in order to fulfill your this goal in this lifetime. You cannot just afford to do mistakes in the getting into the depth of the details, in getting into the intricate details of the life. Then only if you are abiding by the positive side of your destiny number, then only you will be able to fulfill the biggest lesson of your lifetime. Let's say, for example, even if you have a life path number 8. Now 8 is a number which is about the power, which is about the wisdom, which is about the valuing the money. So with a matching, let's say, destiny number or the expression number as 7, you cannot ignore the fact that the path towards the authority, the path towards the wisdom goes by you know, remaining very spick and span with the details. That might be case that the whole, you know, the humankind and the people will be knocking your doors for all kind of, you know, knowledge, all kind of wisdom. You might be playing the role of a teacher, you might be playing the role of an instructor all around you, people who are all around you. That might be a case that even if you are struck in a situation that you are, you know, finding yourself very aloof, very cordoned off, very lonely, even in the midst of a crowd, but still in the mind and mentally and internally you are processing the information. It's always advisable and recommended to someone who has a destiny or the expression number 7 that person should be more attuned inside with his inner soul. There he might get the solution to all of his problems in a sudden flash of light from the intuition, from the, you know, any kind of clairvoyance, any kind of dreams, any sudden happening of the event, any kind of epiphanies. But yes, the path towards the success for a destiny or the expression number 7 lies in perfection, in brilliance, in strong mental qualities and remaining attuned with the soul. So this is all what I wanted to say as my take on the destiny or the expression number 7. It's a highly intuitive number. The best part about this number is that why these people are called as the perfectionist. Because first of all, these people have the capacity to cultivate knowledge, extract the knowledge, they have the capacity to live life on a divine standard. Second thing is, whatsoever whatsoever information they have extracted, they have the capacity to probe on it, to work on it. And best part is that even if there are certain traces of the information which are being left unworked, so their intuition is also going to help them in order to find and land to the ultimate solution. So this is all what I wanted to say. I hope you guys found this video informational. For further more updates and notification on numerology, please subscribe my channel and like my Facebook page. Thanks.